Tank Bigsby has been the go-to back the last couple of weeks. Shivers back 100%. He gets taken down in the backfield. It's Sam Williams with the big hit and a loss of four. Matt Corral and Jerrion Ealy in the backfield. Ealy, two sports star at Ole Miss, also plays baseball, and that was part of the style. Coach Bianco is going to rock a football jersey, but he also said, let's see if we can get John Rhys Plumlee in the game. And Jordan, we talked to him about it yesterday, and he was pretty upfront about it. As Ealy goes down in the backfield,
this goes, I expect to see Plumlee at some point.
Here's a keeper by Corral. Enough legs to keep him honest and pick up a first down. Very patient approach for Ole Miss. Yeboah, the tight end in the backfield. Big hole on the right side for Snoop Connor. And he's blasting dudes inside the 10. It's a 19-yard run. He went right through Jordan Peters at the 5.
Elijah Moore in the slot here, though. He's the go-to guy for Matt Corral. It's man Auburn coverage across the board by Auburn. There's going to be an opportunity to win here in man coverage.
Third and goal. Looking to throw. In zone. Intercepted. Picked up by McCreary, and he's going to try to bring it out. A good play to pick it off. Not a smart decision to bring it out. And Roger McCreary has his second pick in as many games. I saw Grant Loy getting loose on the Auburn sideline. Tank Bigsby is now in at running back. And running straight ahead, Bigsby rips off a first down run. Bigsby with 8 plays of 20 yards or more in this season, who started the year as a third string running back. Made the first man miss, and now he's rolling right through the heart of that Ole Miss defense, which was gashed by Kentucky for 400 rushing yards. Second and 3. Here's Schwartz again. Popped and dropped by Jalen Jordan for a loss of 1.
100 miles an hour all the time, which you want.
And now Shivers enters, gives him a breather, and picks up a first down. And Auburn just dominating on the ground again.
89, J.J. Pegues, the 300-pound tight end on the left side of the offensive line.
Straight ahead, Tank Bigsby is in. It's a 4-yard touchdown run, and Auburn takes the lead thanks to the ground game.
And athletic, well, this is what you can do with them. You can pull them up and look at the lead block right there that sprung Tank Bigsby for the touchdown. I would love to see J.J. Pegues.
Here's Connor. Nothing on the left side. Auburn's defense all over it. That's Tyrone Truesdale. I think they only have 10 on the field defensively right now. Here's Plumlee straight ahead. Now they had 11, and he beat all 11 of them. John Rhys Plumlee to the outside and brought down by a shoelace. It's a 35-yard sprint.
See if they get him outside the pocket here.
They do. He throws into the end zone for a touchdown. A 6-yard strike to Elijah Moore.
Exactly what you want. Big, big opportunity for Matt Corral to get some mojo, get some juice, get some confidence back. Because Ole Miss will need it. Now it's going to be a tie ball game. In order to be elite, they got to be able to push the ball down the field. And that lays on Bo Nix.
And they do it with Shivers here. And he takes off for 14 yards. And you feel the heat on the stove getting turned up on this Auburn team as a whole in the program. Here's Shivers again. And Shivers is able to pick up another first down.
Watch for
that relationship is trust. In the air to the slant, Seth Williams has a hurdle. Wow, what a play by the junior. 10th play of the drive for Auburn. Nix keeps it, tucks it, and he finds the end zone. Zone read, and it's a 4-yard touchdown run for Nix.
Auburn keeps putting receivers to one side and going zone read opposite. And when you got a quarterback that's athletic, it's a one-on-one situation.
Well, one fixed last week, 6 interceptions in that game. Ealy blown up on the handoff. Pardon me, that was Elijah Moore.
Penetration here.
Third and short. A walk-in for Corral. 5-yard touchdown run. His first touchdown run of the season. And Ole Miss is able to answer Auburn.
You're not expecting it when the quote-unquote least athletic quarterback of the two is in the game. He can beat you with his legs as well. That's a masterful drive, right? About 15 here to be comfortable for field goal range.
Let a lot of time tick off there. And a tackle made in the backfield. Auburn will have to use a timeout here with a minute to go. Three-man rush. Nix is going to scramble again. Gets taken down out of bounds. He got taken down way out of bounds deep into the Ole Miss bench. Four wide here with Shivers in the backfield, third and nine. You have spy on Nix. Sideline shot. Juggled and incomplete. Fantastic break on the ball in the secondary. On fourth and nine, Elijah Moore awaits. That one went right through his hands. Chapman can't get it away. And Ole Miss will take over inside the 25. 37-yard attempt for Luke Logan. And they're going to fake it. Logan trying to find the edge. He will not. It's a loss of four. And the momentum handed right back to Auburn. Adjustments for Ole Miss before the snap. Connor finds room on the edge. And a first down run for the Rebels.
Auburn trying to get lined up to this one.
Corral looking for that slant. Instead, the wheel route. Down the sideline, plenty of room for Kenny Yeboah. And the tight end stays on his feet. Got a block, and Yeboah rumbles his way for a 61-yard gain. Went for naught. Corral's got it. Nobody sees him. He'll get his second rushing touchdown of the game.
Run receivers down like it's going to be a pass play, but it's not. They were doing this the entire way, but you steal eyes. Ooh, and a little late action there by McClain.
Yeah.
A little frustration there from the Auburn linebacker.
On third and two, they run it with Bigsby. He's got the first down and plenty more. Into Ole Miss territory with a 19-yard punishing run. Nix pulls it back. Flush throws on the run. Deep ball, jump ball. Down at the one. And a 50-50 ball won by Seth Williams for a 38-yard gain. Auburn quick on the ball. Shivers, touchdown Auburn, and the Tigers with the answer. Set up by the third down completion.
50-50 guys in the country, let alone on the field. And then I love the tempo right after.
Corral running for his life now. Can't get rid of it. And he gets taken down in the backfield. Play clock at six. Nix has it. He's got a blocker in front of him. Shanker paves the way. And Bo Nix runs for a first down. Bigsby, left side, stiff arm, dive, touchdown Auburn. What a play by the freshman from 18 yards out.
To the backside linebacker, and that's what makes that hole you see right there for Tank Bigsby. And Cole, add another one to the clicker, because he just keeps so good at the mechanics of that mesh point. It's hard for linebackers to read.
Gives it to Ely this time, bust through the hole. And right into the safety for another first down run for Jarian Ely. Yeboah lead blocker here. Straight ahead. Touchdown, Jarian Ely. 5-yard touchdown run, and Ole Miss a point after away from taking the lead. End zone. Corral celebrate. Rebels have a lead. Replacement right guard Keandre Jones in the game. Four-man rush. Pressured. Taken down from behind, Sam Williams with the sack. Nix sideline shot. Seth Williams has it and he's free. Down the sideline. Touchdown Auburn, 58 yards.
On the outside, this is a great back shoulder throw. Look at the ball location. In the range by Seth Williams to go get it. And when the DBs lose sight of the ball,
they'll roll Nix, looking in zone. Fires across his body in for the two-point conversion. He finds Williams again. Seconds to go. Last play of the game. Corral steps up through traffic. Has time to direct. We got a flag on the play. He lobs it to the five, past the line of scrimmage anyway, and it's intercepted by Auburn's Jordan Peters, who will run out of bounds and run away with the victory.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.